familiar with this, right, this is actually the 20-year bond, right, or the 20-year notes. I can't really differentiate over here. All right, now, so I know it's called the 10-year notes and the 30-year bonds. Okay, I just don't remember what the 20-year is called. Okay, but this basically measures the prices of the 20-year notes or the 20-year bonds over here that is traded in the markets. Now, but what happens over here is this. Many people get very confused about this product. All right, now, give me a minute. Now, what do I mean when I say many people are confused about this product? Because when you actually see the prices going down over here, right now, the lower these prices go, it actually means that interest rates are actually going up. Yeah, okay, now, so what you're seeing right now is the prices over here is actually indirectly related to the interest rates that are being paid out on these bonds over here. Yeah, okay, now, so the lower the prices are, the higher the interest rates actually become. Right now, and this is actually a concern for the market right now. Now, why do I say this is actually a concern for everyone over here? Now, that's because, all right, when interest rates are going up, it brings about what we call the fear of inflation. Okay, now, as we can see right now, okay, now, this down move in the bonds, right, and bringing up the interest rates over here is actually very, very favorable for what we call the banking stocks. Okay, now, when we call the banking stocks over here, you can see the direct effect over here, because if I were to pull out, for example, some banking stocks over here, right, so if we pull out JP Morgan, oops. All right, you could see that. Oh, my apologies, everyone. All right, you could actually see that when the bond prices were actually going down, right? Okay, as you can see my arrows over here, right? You could see that JP Morgan was actually going up. And it's not just JP Morgan as well. All right, if I were to pull up Bank of America, it looks the same. If I pull out Wells Fargo, it looks the same. Yeah, all right. So across the board, most banking stocks have actually benefited from this, you know, increase in interest rates. Now, why do we say this? We say this because, how do I say this? Higher interest rates are actually better profits for the banks because they borrow at a low interest rates from the government, which is the bonds over here, and they're actually able to loan out at higher interest rates because of what the market is trading the interest rates at. Okay, but there is this point over here where it actually snaps the market instead, right? Because right now, right, it's moving down at a very, very fast pace, right? And when the prices are moving down at a very fast pace, what's happening right now is that actually pushing up the interest rates very, very fast. Okay, now, while all of you may be familiar with the symbol just now, which I shared with you called TLT, right? Now, you may not be familiar with this other one over here called the TNX. All right, now TNX over here is actually a measure of the interest rate itself. Okay, now how do you read this over here? Right, now how you read this is basically like that. All right, when we were somewhere in the beginning of this year, which is, you know, the start of January over here, right, you could see that the value over here was trading around 9 point something. Yeah, all right, let me bring up the crosshair over here and see the prices. All right, so as you can see, it's 9.23. All right, all the way to the right over here, you see it's about 9.3. Okay, now, what do we mean when we see a 9.3 over here? It simply tells you that the interest rate back then was trading at 0.93%. Yeah, okay, all right. So it just means that interest rates was trading at 0.93%, right? But as you can see right now, it has recently hit a high of 13.62, everyone. All right, and today it's 13.45. Now, what does this mean? It actually means that interest rates right now have gone to 1.345, everyone. Okay, 1.345. Now, if you look at this over here, you take 1.345 and you divide it out by 0.93, you have realized that the interest rate has spiked up by about 50%, right? 50% spike in interest rates in just the last 2 months alone. Right now, of course, you know, when this works in the bank's favor, right, the initial part over here may look, you know, very positive for the banks because people see it in a very positive manner, right, whereby, you know, the banks over here will be able to make more profits and they haven't been able to do so for a very, very long time. Okay, but can you imagine if, you know, this escalation continues? That means if the interest rate continues to go up so fast, all right, it will actually cause inflation in the whole economy, and then indirectly, it will cause, you know, panic in the economy instead. Yeah, okay, all right, now. So because of that over here, you can actually, you know, break the back of this market. Yeah, okay, because when people start to fear about this market over here, everything may actually turn around. Yeah, okay, and when it turns around over here, it may lead to uglier perspectives and uglier aspects over here. Yeah, okay, all right. Now, so this is definitely something we have to be very, very, very concerned about. Okay, now, so with this, in fact, over here, I realized one thing, all right? Now, that means, okay, the only way for this market right now, okay, to continue chugging along upwards, that means, you know, we have this target right now, which is about 4,000, all right? The only way the market has a chance, okay, of hitting that 4,000 mark is if we start to see interest rates starts to, you know, swivel around here. Yeah, okay, all right. That means, okay, we go back to bond prices over here, right? TLT, let me erase all this right now, right? The only way the market has a chance right now to continue going up, right, is if we start to see this TLT prices start to move in a sideways channel. Yeah, all right, okay. Now, why do we do this? Because, right, if TLT starts to rebound and shoots back up very quickly, right, what's gonna happen? Right, this down move, all right, remember everyone, this down move made the bank stocks go up, all right? So if this has a sudden swing back upwards over here, what's going to happen to the financial stocks? The financial stocks are going to come down, all right? And you realize the weird thing over here, everyone. When the financial stock starts to come down, all right, it will drag the S&P along with it. So this is also negative, all right? Now, so we are in a catch-22 situation right now with the bonds. Right, and the bonds are not controlled by retail investors. You must understand this. The bonds are controlled by the big investors, the professional investors, and the funds out there. Yeah, right. Because this product is just too big to be traded, and retail investors seldom trade it because they don't understand it very well. Right now, so what happens right now is the professionals are positioning themselves, all right, way ahead of the market. They're positioning themselves so that they don't get risked out. Okay, because we start to see a lot of this warning over here, you know, in the markets by some affluent and big name investors, all right, warning about the hyperinflations and, you know, how overvalued the entire market is. But yet, it's not able, you know, it's not ready to roll over and die. Okay, now, but suddenly the risk is there. So a lot of these professional investors are taking up their positions, right, in the bond product instead. Yeah, okay, so that's what's happening right now. So, you know, it's a catch-22 because if bond prices continue to break downwards, okay, that means very swiftly it continues this downtrend over here, all right, it's going to cause the market to collapse, okay? And yet, if it violently rebounds very quickly, it's also going to cause the market to collapse, all right? So now, the only thing you can do to keep the market the way it is actually to move, all right, in a sideways channel over here. All right, okay, now, so this is the market update that I want to bring to everyone, all right, and this is why I do feel that the market is right now in, you know, that very, very sensitive phase right now, the very, very